Tau Ceti may have 8 planets, one in the habitable zone. Have you ever thought about how many planets out there might be able to support life like ours? It's not just about the stars. The main characters of the show are the planets that go around them. With billions of stars, just think about how many of them there could be in the whole universe. Scientists got excited about this idea and figured out ways to find and explore these planets called exoplanets. But finding them is tricky. Even if scientists spot something, it's hard to be sure if it's a real planet or just a mistake in their measurements. One thing is for sure, not all stars are equally good for finding life. Some, like Tau Ceti, are better candidates, and astronomers know this well. In this video, I'll share the story of why scientists believe Tau Ceti might have a remarkable 8 planets, just like our own solar system. Tau Ceti, similarities to our Sun. Tau Ceti, like most stars in the universe, leads a fairly ordinary existence without any noteworthy characteristics. It is similar to our own Sun in terms of its uneventful life cycle. Unlike other stars that emit dangerous radiation or expand into red giants, Tau Ceti, classified as a G-class star, remains quite tranquil. Occasionally, it may exhibit solar flares or eruptions, but nothing of significant concern. If you were to replace our Sun with Tau Ceti, the only noticeable difference would be a slight drop in temperature on Earth, as Tau Ceti has a slightly smaller radius of 0.79 compared to the Sun. Additionally, its surface temperature is around 5,320 Kelvin. Tau Ceti is currently known as the nearest G star to the Sun. The main distinction between these two stars lies in their metallicity, with Tau Ceti lacking the same abundance of metals as the Sun. This difference is crucial and will be addressed later. Scientists initially believed that Tau Ceti's low metallicity would prevent the formation of planets in its system. However, reality tends to be more complex than our theories, and we have indeed discovered planets orbiting Tau Ceti. In December of 2012, the announcement was made that 5 super-Earth-like planets had been found, 2 of which were within the habitable zone of the system. Additionally, a debris disk exists within the system, containing a much higher quantity of matter, including asteroids and comets, compared to similar structures in our solar system. This is both shocking and amazing. I'm sure Freddie Mercury would ask, is this real life or is it just fantasy? But let's proceed with order. A perfect candidate for life as we know it. Understanding planetary habitability begins with analyzing the properties of the host star. Specifically, the temperature of the star is crucial, with the ideal range for habitable stars falling between 7,000 Kelvin and 4,000 Kelvin. For reference, our Sun has a photospheric temperature of 5,777 Kelvin, placing it comfortably within this range. Unfortunately, this spectral range is believed to encompass only 5 to 10% of the stars in our galaxy. However, Tau Ceti is one of the fortunate stars within this range. Another important factor to consider is the type of star. Some stars have such short lifespans that they don't even have the opportunity to form planets. Stars in the O and B classes, which are more luminous main-sequence stars, typically exist for less than 500 million years. Additionally, these stars emit excessive amounts of ultraviolet radiation, which could potentially annihilate any budding life forms. For a star to support habitability, it should emit sufficient high-frequency radiation to drive crucial atmospheric processes, like ozone formation. However, it should not emit so much radiation that it ionizes the atmosphere, leading to the demise of all organisms on orbiting planets. Luckily, Tau Ceti is not a hazardous star, as its radiation is suitable for sustaining an Earth-like planet's atmosphere. Another advantage is that Tau Ceti is a solitary star and not part of a multiple star system. In most cases, stars are found in binary or multiple systems, and astronomers are actively determining the prevalence of planets within these systems. Some planets orbit a single star, while others orbit both simultaneously. However, life on these planets may face challenges, as multiple stars can disrupt a planet's orbit, making survival difficult for life as we know it. Additionally, the habitable zones of these planets can undergo significant challenges as the stars move in relation to each other. Thankfully, Tau Ceti, being a single star, eliminates these concerns. These reasons make Tau Ceti an intriguing subject of study in the search for life as we understand it. looking for alien signals in Tau Ceti. Undoubtedly, Tau Ceti has quickly gained immense popularity among the scientific community. Numerous experiments and projects were funded throughout the years to conduct more detailed studies on it. One notable endeavor is Project OSMA, which took place in 1960. Led by radio astronomer Frank Drake, it marked humanity's first modern effort to detect interstellar radio transmissions. Drake firmly believed that if there were any intelligent life on a planet orbiting Tau Ceti, we would have detected the signals they were potentially sending to Earth through radio transmissions. For several hours a day, between April and July of 1960, the 85-foot antenna's receiver was tuned to the frequency of the interstellar hydrogen emission line, known as the 21-centimeter emission line. The assumption was that this frequency, 1420 MHz, would be universally recognized by technologically advanced societies as a hailing frequency. Using existing receivers and technology, Drake intentionally avoided excessive spending on the OSMA project to prevent criticism over what some might consider a frivolous experiment. The OSMA team, consisting of only a few members, monitored the antenna's incoming signals using a chart recorder and a loudspeaker. Aside from an initial false alarm likely caused by aircraft radar, the only sound that emanated from the loudspeaker was static, and no discernible patterns appeared on the chart recorder. Although no extraterrestrial life was discovered, this groundbreaking experiment paved the way for future searches for signals originating from other stars. Within a year, the first scientific meeting discussing the potential for such searches took place in Green Bank, where the renowned Drake equation was introduced. This equation provides an estimate of the number of potentially detectable electromagnetic emissions from civilizations within the Milky Way. In 1995, Project Phoenix took a similar approach. It consisted of a radio campaign utilizing a single-dish radio telescope called the Parkes Radio Telescope, located in the Southern Hemisphere. This telescope was the largest of its kind at that time. However, in August of 1998, the project relocated to Arecibo. Unlike previous searches, Phoenix did not conduct a comprehensive scan of the entire sky. Instead, it focused on examining the area surrounding nearby stars that resembled our Sun. These stars were believed to be more likely to possess planets capable of sustaining life. Naturally, stars already known to have planets were also included in the observations. Approximately 800 star systems within a distance of about 200 light-years were observed by Project Phoenix. Despite the diligent efforts invested, no extraterrestrial signal was detected. Nonetheless, a bright future was ahead of us. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The unexpected discovery. Mark your calendars. On December 19, 2012, an astounding discovery was made regarding the Tau Ceti star. Through an analysis of its radial velocity, scientists found not just one, not two, but a remarkable total of more than five planets orbiting around Tau Ceti. This revelation was truly mind-blowing. Since 1988, researchers have been diligently studying the star's radial velocity to uncover the existence of massive planets resembling Jupiter around Tau Ceti, but their efforts were in vain. However, this wasn't necessarily bad news, as the presence of a scorching hot Jupiter or an eccentric Jupiter would have destabilized the orbits of any potentially habitable rocky planets in the system. Additionally, the Hubble Space Telescope had already ruled out the existence of brown dwarfs or extremely massive planets orbiting companions. Due to a lack of technology, nobody had specifically sought out planets similar to Earth or slightly more massive. Then in 2012, the discovery of these five planets within minimum masses ranging from 2 to 7 times that of Earth, classified as super-Earths, brought about a monumental shift. These new planets boasted orbital periods spanning from 14 to 640 days. Notably, Tau Ceti E, one of the planets in question, is situated at a distance half that of Earth from the Sun. This would have posed a problem if Tau Ceti emitted as much heat as our Sun. Fortunately, this is not the case. Being less radiant than our star, Tau Ceti finds itself within the habitable zone, where the presence of liquid water on the planet's surface becomes a feasible possibility. How would the sky look like from Tau Ceti E? If we were to imagine ourselves on a planet orbiting Tau Ceti, The view of the sky wouldn't be vastly different from what we see in our own solar system. The main distinction would be that certain stars, which have varying distances from Tau Ceti compared to the Sun, would have different levels of apparent brightness. The Sun, for instance, would appear as a star with a magnitude of 2.6 near the star Epsilon in the constellation Bootes, not far from the brighter Arcturus. Arcturus, being 46 light-years away from Tau Ceti, would therefore appear slightly dimmer than it does from Earth, with a magnitude of 0.56. Similarly, Vega, located 32 light-years from Tau Ceti, would also appear fainter, as would Sirius, which is over 12 light-years away. Sirius would have the same brightness as Canopus, since Canopus would be the brightest star in the sky with a magnitude of -0.65. Alpha Centauri, which is 13.5 light-years away from Tau Ceti, would be noticeably dimmer than it appears from Earth, but slightly brighter than the Sun with a magnitude of +2.47. The stars YZ Ceti and the Luton system 726-8, which are closest to Tau Ceti, would not be visible to the naked eye due to their low luminosity. On the other hand, Epsilon Eridani, the third closest star to Tau Ceti, would appear significantly brighter than it does from Earth. Despite being 5.5 light-years away, it would shine with a magnitude of 2.31, making it even slightly brighter than the Sun. The mind-blowing prediction of four more planets. And of all the planets found around Tau Ceti, only four have been confirmed. However, American astronomers have made an exciting discovery. They have developed a unique method to determine if they are undiscovered planets in systems like Tau Ceti. By combining existing knowledge about a planetary system with statistical rules, they can predict the presence and size of yet undetected planets, much like filling in missing pieces of a puzzle. This new analysis can aid in the discovery of new planets, assist in mapping planetary systems in our solar neighborhood, and guide future searches for extraterrestrial life. The astronomers have named their model Dynamite, which uses four factors to predict hidden worlds: the location and sizes of currently known planets in a system, the likelihood of them being closer to the star, the stability of the planetary system, and mathematical patterns in adjacent planet orbits. Applying the Dynamite model to the Tau Ceti system, where four planets have been confirmed but other candidates remain unconfirmed, they predict that three of these candidates are actual planets. However, the predictions go beyond that. According to Dynamite, there is another unseen planet in Tau Ceti's temperate zone. This planet is likely to be gaseous, similar to Neptune, but smaller and warmer. However, there is a higher chance that it is a rocky planet, albeit larger than Earth. With the latest planet-hunting instruments, this world may be detectable in the coming years. If confirmed, it would be a significant target for future searches for life. In a nutshell, Tau Ceti's future holds profound exploration. If life lies out there, it seeks refuge among stars akin to Tau Ceti. If not, we probably are a cosmic rarity. Sounds thrilling, doesn't it? That's all for this video. As we conclude our celestial journey, feel free to share your thoughts on this video in the comments below. Do you think we'll ever find life on Tau Ceti? We'll see you soon on the channel.